Nice. Hello everyone, in today's video I'm going to show you how to make a gift tag, and this is a super easy design, but if you're new to using Canva, then this tutorial is for you, because I will explain step by step how you can make this gift tag yourself. I am using the free version of Canva, and if you log into Canva, then you will see this page. On the top right corner you can create a design, and we are going to do that. I choose custom size and type these dimensions in. And then I click on create a design, and then Canva sends you to your project. You will always start with a blank canvas. I think you probably don't have these rulers here and here, but if you want to have them too, you can get them easily by clicking on your keyboard on Shift plus R. I recommend having them because sometimes it's easier to work and you can easily mark things with these guidelines. If you want to remove the guidelines, then select the guideline and click on backspace on your keyboard, or use this icon. It's from Canva itself. Okay, we're really going to start now. Click on element in the left toolbar and search for gift tags in the search bar. If you have the pro version of Canva, then you can use these images with a crown. If you don't have that, then you can use it, but you have to pay for it. And because I want to show this video as free as possible, I don't recommend it. So I'm going to show you now how you can make such tags with a shape. You have to still stay in elements, but you click on the cross and then you see shapes. Click on see all, and then you see all the shapes of Canva. And these shapes are free for everyone to use. I select the gift tag shape, and that everyone knows, I think. It turns green for me because it's automatically set to my color palette, and so it might be a different color for you, but the good thing is that you can change these colors. I rotate my tag as you can see, and then I place it exactly in the middle. You can measure this with the automatic pink lines that appear, and then I select it in the toolbar above color border style, and choose a border for my gift tag, and that becomes black. And then I make the tag a little bigger again and change the inside color to white or transparent. Choose a color you like. You need to know if you make the inside transparent and you're going to print, for example, on pink paper, then the inside of your tag will also be pink because you made that shape transparent. If you don't want that, then I recommend choose the color white. I totally forgot to film the guideline dimensions, but these are the ones you should use. Now I'm going to create a fun and easy design. I click on text in the left corner and select the subheading. It doesn't really matter which text you click on. I write the sentence that I want to say and on the tag, which is a gift for you. If you select all the text and click on this icon, then your letters will all be in caps lock. This is what I want, so I click on that. And then I click on this button where you can find letter spacing and line spacing. And I'm going to play around with it a bit, so try it out for yourself because this way you learn what you are doing. Then it's important to select your gift tag shape and click on the lock button. This will lock your tag shape, so when you select the text and move it to the right position, your shape will not move with it. Then I'm going to choose a fun font, and for me it's that UA. I think it looks quite festive, and you can choose from a lot of fonts, so be sure to explore and find what you like. I will make the text bigger, and I do that by clicking on these round points. Then I will position it again, and next I go back to the left toolbar and select text. It doesn't really matter which text you choose, I select subheading again, and then I write 2 in it. I make the text bold and also set it in caps lock and line it out to the left. So this tag will be an easy design, and if you have, for example, your own business and only want to put the receiver's name there, or if you want to make multiple tags, then this is a tag that you can use for multiple occasions. As you can see, I'm using a guideline. I do this because I'm going to copy the text too. I use these shortcuts on my keyboard, and then I've copied the text too. So I only need to slide it down. But I want to ensure that it's aligned correctly. That is the whole reason that I use guidelines. And then I change the text to form. You can also leave it as 2 if you're making the text for a different occasion, like your small business or something. You can skip what I'm going to show you, or if you struggle to write straight, I suggest picking a dotted shape. If you're holding down the shift key on your keyboard, then it will help you position the shape precisely. Otherwise, it might move unpredictably, and I used this shape twice and placed it behind both to and from. And again, I use guidelines for this because it is easier working and you know it will be good. And then I'm going to give each letter a different color to make the design a little bit more fun. I select each letter and then I choose the color. Of course, you can choose your design completely yourself, so do what you think looks nice. Okay, fast forward. I select the tag and I unlock it, and then I click on the tag shape, and then I give the border style a different color. And then I select the text to and from and give them the same color, pink. And then next, I select the dotted lines and give them a gradient color which looks like this. To finish the tag, I'm going to look for a cute graphic image. I select elements in the left toolbar and then I search for a little present or gift. You should know that if you have the pro version of Canva, you can choose from multiple cute graphic images. Since I'm using the free version, I go for something simple for now. Another option, if you have your own small business, is to use your logo instead of a graphic image. I chose these little presents, and if you're using a graphic image, you can easily give them another color. I give them a pink color because it fits with my design. This next step is optional. I search for a round shape in the elements toolbar because I'm going to print these tags at home, and I have a hole puncher. I'm not sure what this is called in English. I don't know if this is the good word, but I'm going to edit this video later, and now there will be a picture in the screen. So now you can see what it is, what I mean. But if I do the text separately underneath this puncher, then I can measure the round holes properly. Okay, the design is finished. If you want to print these gift tags at home, what you need to do is select everything on the screen and group it. Then do the right click on your mouse and a menu will appear. Select copy. I opened a new tab on my browser from Canva and I create a new document, which is an A4 portrait document, and you will start again with a blank canvas. Then paste your design. You can put 4 tags next to each other and in total you will have 12. I totally forgot to film the guidelines, but these are the dimensions for the gift tags to print them out on an A4 document. I will show you the guidelines step by step. You have to watch the screen for this. You can also see that I changed the present, so each tag is a little bit different. And now I'm going to show you how I printed these tags at home. I select download in the top right corner and choose PDF print. You can also choose JPG, but PDF print is the best format for these gift tags. If you have the Canva Pro version, I recommend choosing the CMYK color profile because that option is specially for print. However, I'm going for PDF print and RGB right now because I don't use the Canva Pro version this time. I hope this video was helpful to you. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comment section below, and I do my best to assist you if you face any issues. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video, and don't forget to give it a like and consider subscribing.